Been all over CNN and MSNBC, but you saw the story first on Five.
And tonight, the school called a special meeting to deal with the short skirt outrage. Once and for all, this host Karen Johnson is live with tonight's top story. Karen?
And that meeting just ended moments ago, and it did not turn out the way parents had hoped. Many parents still upset tonight. Cheerleaders right there walking out of the door. They tell me it was more of a talk where administrators laid out the rules, and it stands as is. And that's what I figured would happen, considering the district is just not happy with all the attention it's been getting.
Everybody out, go, big blue!
It's hard to bring these spirits down. But mention the school's new dress code to the Monroe cheerleaders, and you'll be surprised.
If we're allowed to wear them at games, you should be allowed to wear them in school to wear to like the pep rallies and stuff.
Not in the superintendent's book. She's made it clear these skirts are only to be worn during games and assemblies. Wearing them to class is now off limits.
They conform to the sport and the event, but they aren't appropriate for school coursework all day long.
Dr. Lolly is enforcing the dress code that states all shorts and skirts should be no shorter than 3 inches above the knee. Cheerleading skirts are no exception because some claim they're distracting. Students we talk to don't all agree.
As cheerleaders and the girls, it doesn't seem too bad of a problem.
I think it's kind of ridiculous because they are cheerleaders and they're like supporting the school and what they do.
But no matter how many peers come to the cheerleaders' defense, Lolly says she's standing strong on her decision. And I'm being told right now that the cheerleading squad has been told to go, not allowed to talk to the media. They're very upset tonight. They tell me the district did say they'll pay for T-shirts that they could wear with jeans, but parents and cheerleaders say it's not the same. Live in Monroe, Karen Johnson, News 5.